Hello, in this short video I would like to show and to demonstrate how to do in FFT a fast Fourier transform in MATLAB from scratch. So the story goes like this. A student, let's call him Pete, sent me this email asking for some help, for some advice. He has a problem using this Fourier function because of missing arguments, incorrect arguments, whatever. So I asked him back to provide me the data. He sent me the data. Here's the data. So let's have a look at the data, import it in MATLAB. And now we can see, okay, there are two matrices in there. Both have a large number of rows and two columns. So the first column might be the time. The second column might be some function value. So let's load these matrices. Now we have them there. And so now I will extract the values from these matrices. Start with the first one, take all rows, take the first column, save this as t for the time. And now I will take x of t, the function values, the same matrix, all rows, second column, and plot these together. So the function values as a function of the time. And there is the plot, and we can see, okay, looks like some noisy data, but there is some discontinuity there, some missing points, probably because the function is not a number there. So we can check, is the function not a number? Is any of these values not a number? And yes, it is. So in this case, if we have a discontinuity like this, an FFT won't work, because now if we calculate the spectrum, all the values in the spectrum would be not a number if there is such a discontinuity. So we could cut this out and use just the remaining data points, but here it's not so easy to do this FFT analysis. So now let's have a look at the second matrix. So once again, I will take all the all the rows from the first column, save it as the time, take all the values from the second column, save it as the time function values, and plot it once again. There's the plot. And then we can see, okay, now once again, it looks like noisy data, but there seems to be no discontinuity, so it might be possible to do some FFT here. So we can repeat this check and check, is there some value which is not a number? And this is not the case. So now we would like to use is this Fourier function. So I will open it up in the editor here, and we can see, okay, it takes the time steps and the function values, and there are some comments here. It's always a good idea to read the comments from these functions that you are using. So the comments here is the first time step should be zero and there should be equidistant time steps. So if we take a look once again back at the plot, we see, okay, the first time step is not obviously not zero. It's something like, good question if these are seconds here. I will assume that these are seconds. So we at first we need to get this first time step to be zero. So how do we do this? Easy solution. At first, what I will do is I will copy everything that I have more or less done now and put it into some script and start the script with clear all, close all. And then, of course, my workspace is empty, so I also need to load the data once again. Extract the time steps, extract these time values and plot them. And before plotting, I will take all the time steps and subtract the first time step, or the time of the first time step. So if we do it like this, and now I will save it as FFT example and run it. One missing character or one wrong character there. So now it works, and now we can see, okay, we are starting with zero. So now I would like to label the axis here a little bit and say on the x-axis this is the time. I will assume it's in seconds, and on the y label this is our function. in, I don't know, in some unit. That we don't know, that I don't know at least. And yeah, plot it once again. Okay, now we have access labels, and now I want to zoom a little bit in there, and you can see it's really a lot of data points. So it takes some time in MATLAB to plot and to rescale. And so we can see, okay, there's a very, 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 very slow oscillation. But if we zoom in, we see that there is a more rapid oscillation. So let's zoom in more and zoom in even more. And now we can see, okay, there's a really, really rapid, not so really, really rapid, but there's some oscillation. Okay, here is the oscillation. And so now we can check that the periodic time. So if I take a data cursor, here's the maximum at 38 seconds, and here's another maximum at 60 something seconds, and the next one is at around 90 and at around 115 and so on. So I think it's the difference from here to here is something like 25. Once again, 25, once again, something like 25, once again, something like 25 seconds. And so we can calculate if we take 1 over 25 seconds, our frequency, the main frequency component that we should get in there in the spectrum should be something like 0.04 hertz, 40 millihertz. 0.04 hertz. So now, okay, let's take this Fourier function. Let's really calculate the spectrum. And put this here. No, I will copy the whole thing. And okay, we already have the time. We already have these function values as a function of the time. We need to have this mode, and the mode is also somewhere explained here. If we have a more or less continuous signal, and this is what we have, the mode should be sinus or sine. And now using this Fourier function, we can calculate the frequencies and the corresponding spectral amplitude values, or the corresponding spectrum as a complex value. So now we can, if we have calculated this, we can plot this. And as said, this is a complex value, so it might be a good idea to take only the absolute value of this and plot this. And I will once again already label the axis and say this is the frequency in hertz. And the y label is the same, the function in some unit. And I will plot this in the second figure so that we have both of these figures at the same time and can switch between them. Okay, so here's the first figure once again, that where I've just zoomed in, and here's our spectrum. And now we can see, okay, take a look back. This function here, it does not oscillate around zero. There is some DC part, and the DC part is around 0.7. And then this oscillation that we have seen, the amplitude of the oscillation is something like 0.2-ish, 0.3, 0.25, something like this. And then it goes up and down and up and down. But I'm not sure if the amplitude was really that high. Let's zoom in there once again. As you can see, no, the amplitude is a little smaller. It's only, so the total amplitude is maybe 0.3. So the amplitude is just 0.15, something like this. And then of course it's changing here over the whole time range. So this is not a very steady signal. But if we take a look at the spectrum now, take a look at the second figure. Okay, we can see that really at 0.04, at 40 millihertz, at 0.04 hertz, we have a spectral component. And the amplitude of the spectral component is really something like 0.15, what we have just seen here. So this seems to work. And of course, there are some harmonics related to this. I would try to display this in a little different way in a second. And these are really the two main, more or less two main frequency components. Everything else, there is just nothing. And then we have this DC part here. And let's try to zoom into this DC part. And the DC part, as said, should be what we see here, 0.7. But we see the DC part twice here. So we see twice this value. So we see something like 1.4. But as you can see, this did not look that nice. So let's not plot it with the linear axis scaling. Let's plot it with logarithmic axis scaling. So we have a double logarithmic display of the spectrum and plot it once again. And now we can see, okay, this what we see here, this is everything is more or less just noise. And these are here the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but these are really the two main important frequency spectrum components. And once again, if we have this data tip here, one is around 41.7 millihertz and the other one is at around twice this frequency, 80.5 something millihertz. And now, of course, you could also zoom in here and now we can see, okay, it's not really just this one frequency. There are some, I don't know really what this is. For me as an EMC engineer, a little bit looks like a modulation. Yeah, so we have some center frequency and we have some, or some carrier frequency and some left and right side bands. Also the same here, but I think of course it's not a modulated signal. It's I don't know, maybe some measured data. I don't have a clue, but this is the way how you could do an FFT, a fast Fourier transform from this data in MATLAB to calculate the amplitude spectrum. What I almost forgot to mention is, if you are also facing problems in MATLAB and if you would like to send me your source code, your MATLAB files to take a look at them, make sure that you have done this MATLAB on-ramp course before, because it's a really good course. It really deals with the basic usage of MATLAB, and by doing this course you can be sure that you don't have this whatever missing arguments, wrong arguments, unlogical arguments, something like this. Then if this does not fix your problem, if you still would like to send me your code, make sure that you really attach it to the email, preferably as a zipped file, that if there are many MATLAB files, clearly indicate what is the main program or which is the main script that one needs to run to replicate your problem. Make sure that most of the files run on your computer without obvious problems or errors. Then I have not done this in my example here, but I will add this later just for brevity. I've omitted this in the video, but make sure that there's really a meaningful comment on each and every line. What does each and every line does in your program? What is the usage of it? What is the meaning of it? Why you have this line there? Describe what the program should do. What should be the desired output and what is any discrepancy from that, and what is the problem that you would like to have solved. And don't send me files which are not really necessary to understand your problem. And if you have questions, have them as specific as possible. Thank you.